It is those of us who do not fear that bring the fight to the crook that rattles them and shakes their cage and brings their house of cards tumbling down.
And I'm not a BSer. $100,000 is going to be in a check to you today, and I demand. I have listeners that I know are billionaires who have offered me millions of dollars. I never asked for it because I fund myself. I'm going to call them and I'm going to say, you know what? Let's put a million on this because I can tell we are on the target. Go ahead.
Yeah, well, I'm trying to get a hold of the You Caring website to find out what violation they are claiming, and they won't respond. So,
and we have the screenshots.
What problem could they have with what we are doing? I mean, this is as straightforward as it gets. You know, we want to prevent children from being abused by pedophiles. That's pretty honorable stuff, no matter how you slice it. So this is concerning.
And you're, again, I'm not kissing your ass because I've talked to people. I mean, I knew who you were, but I know you won't even say what SEAL team you were with or led. But, I mean, you're like as elite as it gets in all the major units. And you've been in all the major units. And you're like, you got all these great. That's why they're so scared. They are shitting their pants. Excuse me. Delayed that. I said I wouldn't do it today. I am so real at this point. You caring within 1 hour. Normally, if something's a fraud razor, it takes days to shut it down. They let jihadis raise money everywhere all over line to kill people. You are saying, as a producer, I want to do a show on sex trafficking, and again, they want to make it about prostitutes that are 20 or something being brought in from Honduras. Okay, great. Stop that. That's what the news does, you know, at NFL games or whatever. You're literally have the sources. That's why they're so scared. This is absolute, like, proof of how you're on target. So I want David to jump in here, and I've got a Don Salazar ready to come in who got the screenshots and contacted him. But just look, I've gone from, like, you know, being concerned about this to totally obsessed with it. They are running scared. What do you think happened at You Caring, one of the big crowdsourcing sites, when a celebrity known veteran super patriot with two TV shows on national cable cannot do a fundraiser for children being for investigations into pedophilia?
Yeah, so it doesn't look good, does it? Again, they've yet to contact me back and answer my question on what's wrong there. What violation are they claiming? I don't even think that they can come up with a violation that they're hanging their hat on. This is really, really. But, you know, we knew this would be an uphill battle and a hard fight. But, boy, it starts straight out of the gate. They don't want this out there. And so it's disgusting to me. If this is part of it, if it's not just a technical glitch, this is pretty pretty sickening to see that whoever at You Caring has a problem with us, you know, exposing pedophilia. So is You Caring involved? Are they complicit? We have no way of knowing until they get back to us and articulate what sort of violation they're claiming, because I can't imagine for the life of me what it would be. This is as straightforward as it gets.
And to be clear, I did my retraction last week. We do retractions all the time. We make a mistake. We're proud of our retractions. We want to be accurate. You have the Podesta emails come out, Spirit Cooking, Aleister Crowley stuff, talk about kids at rituals. I mean, just thousands of emails. I couldn't even read them anymore because it was like in between the rituals and, like, we're going to have lots of blood and semen for you and breast milk. It'd be like, yeah, we're going to screw over our constituents, and you're just reading the nastiness. And then there's all these pizza connotations in the FBI manual. They say that's, you know, cheese pizza, child porn, all that stuff. Then they genius divert in the media off some 4chan comments they probably posted the mainstream onto a pizza place where we couldn't prove it one way or the other. We kind of cover it, go, oh, no, I think they're probably innocent. Then they turn it into, oh, Alex Jones recants, pedophilia doesn't exist anywhere in the world. And so I would imagine they probably just, because that's what they're doing, trolling everywhere. They're trying to roll out that pedophilia doesn't exist. They try to roll out that it's a good thing in Salon and CNN and the Trendies, you know, and all these advertisements for clothing that are all pedophilic. None of that works. So now they're back to we don't exist. So David Knight, I want to bring a Don Salazar in on this. I'm glad Craig was able to pop back in. Stay there, Craig, for more comments. But this just smells like victory. I mean, again, they're saying terms of service, we shut your account down. We hope it's a glitch. I'm sure they're great folks. But I said this to him an hour ago, to Craig. Craig, I said, everything I do on this is instantly shut down in real time. This isn't artificial intelligence. This isn't bots. This is people watching everything we do in live time trying to stop Trump.
Well, it would appear that way. You know, I'm a federal criminal investigator, and I'm inclined to wait and sort through the facts and come to my conclusion based upon that. But all I can say is, meanwhile, it doesn't look good. Until they'll come up with an answer, they're claiming their terms of service have been violated. What is that violation? We need that right now, because
they're saying a federal officer, former top Navy SEAL, national TV show host, and a guy that saved the rhinos is not allowed to raise money to investigate pedophilia.
Yeah. I mean, I think Americans need to be asking some hard questions. What is this claimed violation?
Well, Craig, I'm going to tell you what's about to happen. I've already experienced it. They've tried financial stuff. I can feel it. My guy, they think we're cowards. They're about to go physical. We all need to be on absolute alert right now. I can feel it. This is destiny. I think we're about to beat them. And I'm not just saying that. I don't ever say that on air. I am feeling a moment right now in my gut that I believe we've crossed a threshold with your courage and all our listeners' courage. I believe we're crossing a threshold that if we just stay strong, hold fast, those kids are crying out to God to be saved. And we're doing that. We don't want to be saviors. We're not. It's got to be done. And so, as men, we can't be intimidated by this. We have to ask God to give us a guidance to have victory. Craig, go ahead. I'm sorry.
Let me share this. The reason I went with UCARE is because GoFundMe, when I was wrapping up the campaign with GoFundMe, it seized up. They locked up my account before I was even finished writing it up and attempted to launch
They've
it.
They've got AI. That's what I said. They've got everybody. They've got AI watching what you wrote.
Yeah, that was my question, is why didn't you use GoFundMe? And that's
well, let's not even elaborate. I'm sorry I interrupted.
Let me just paint the picture real quick. I was in the middle of writing it up and I wasn't even going to launch it for a few more days. So I was in the middle of writing it up, and then a notice popped up saying, hey, your account has been locked or something to that effect, and pending further review for 3 days. And I'm like, well, 3 days? I've done these kind of things before, and if they have a question, there's an instant help chat that pops up, and they help you work through
pedophilia, any of this is shut down. And let me just expand. We have reporters like Paul Watson, who is obviously reaches 30, 40 million people a week now, so he's a superstar. Now, we say, like, well, we're stars, but he's able to meet with the top folks that nobody else is to meet with. You know, years ago, Matt Drudge, you name it, like I am. He's been talking to a lot of people, I'll just leave it at that, that are ready to move in England. And they've just been waiting for people like this. And I just want people to know this is game changing. So, Craig, we hope you caring is wrong. It doesn't matter. $100,000. And I'm going to tell the listeners, we've been hit hard. We've been, and I'm not bitching about it. I just want to win. Money is fuel in our coffers. But I think we're just going to have to go. They'll even get into our mail, too. God, I've had them do that before, too. We're just going to have to directly get the money to this organization because they know how real Craig is. What a, you know, it's an insult to say rock star, but just what a prime mover in the great success and the things he's done, the spirit of Christ that he got from his father and everything he's done. And the fact that these men are standing up and they already know what Trump's doing. It's just, we need to pray for everybody and realize that this, we are fighting pure Satanism right now. And I just, if people knew what Craig's gone through the last month, the things I've gone through, and I'm not complaining about it. It's just these people are so bad, and they've got to be broken. We've got to break their backs for the children. Like you said, not in a hateful way, because I tend to hate these people, and it really gets to me. We need to do it for the children. That's where our strength is in love. But now I know we've got to fund what you're doing. So I hope listeners go buy water filters, things you need, X2 that's about to sell out. They're trying to shut off our supply of that because it's such a bestseller. Just anything. They've got intel on us, folks. They're up our ass, and it's okay. I expect this. Just know this is the fight. You want people to fight? This is it. And it's not about us. It's that you want the fight. You're in it, folks. This is it. We're engaging them at point-blank range in 21st century warfare that isn't even about military. It's about information. It's about truth. It's about standing up against bullying and globalist brainwashing, and we're doing it now, and we're having an effect that's the biggest ever. And I'm just humble in this position. But know this. We're under the main enemy assault. We've had more assaults the last 2 months than I've had in 22 years combined. And, folks, I've been attacked by four guys in a parking lot. I have been things you could, and I'm not bitching. It was all honorable. I actually see it as I'm blessed. I'm blessed. But it's been bad. And it's so intense now what they're doing. And just understand, it's because they are got these kids and they are rolling out to go after the flower of our humanity. They believe they've dominated us, and they're finally scared. So I'm going to call you, Craig, after the show. I'm going to see $100,000 for this, and I know it's going to go towards the truth and just what matters, no matter what, whatever platform it is. They'll ban us on YouTube, Google. It doesn't matter. You can't skip this network break. I'm going to come back with the Don Salazar. And David, jump in anytime. But we have to do this because they want to have the silent killing of free speech. It's not going to happen. So we're going to come back. Don Salazar, David Knight, who's such an angel, me running over him. It's just such a moment. Stay with us, InfoWars.com. Spread that link. It's a war. There's desperation in our free society censoring people with Discovery Channel shows and History Channel shows from just doing a GoFundMe for make a film about sex trafficking. I mean, it's everywhere now. You just, sex trafficking, you're banned. It's like, this is the new protected group because they're so desperate, like the Catholic Church, to block it. When this is 100 times bigger, because they know the dam's breaking. Craig, I smell weakness. I don't just say that to be confident. When I feel weak, I'll admit it. I feel confidence right now.
Well, you know, pedophilia can never be a protected group or practice because you have an unwilling victim. It's not something between consenting adults. The child or the infant has no ability to escape or say no. So that's what makes this so bad and so unacceptable.
And David has a key point. The mass sacrifice is the babies and people being indicted for showing the babies being kept alive and being harvested. David?
Yeah, I wanted to talk about that. But you know, when you talked about they can never make this accepted because we do not have consenting adults, okay? That's what all of this stuff about transgenderism is, as far as I'm concerned. It's about saying that we can have 5, 6, 7-year-olds decide that they want to be a...
The government can discuss the sex of your kid and do things you don't tell them until they're 12. They're in your life at age 5. It's goddamn pedophilia.
Well, you can have the teacher, you can have a psychiatrist, or you can have the parents or whatever telling them, no, I think we want to change your sex or something. So if they can do that, and the kid can make that determination at the early ages that we're seeing now, then what they're setting up down the road is the idea that there is no age of consent. So, therefore, pedophilia goes...
California said age of consent on vaccines is 10.
Yeah, absolutely.
Sorry, David, keep going. David's a genius
here.
But
the other thing, too, Craig, was we just talked about the Center for Medical Progress. They were charged with 15 charges of violating people's privacy because they recorded these interactions with people that they... We're doing an undercover investigation. They had information. They believed that they were butchering these kids and selling the body parts for profit. So they did this undercover investigation, released this when these people made these confessions. And then, of course, what do we see? We see them coming after the whistleblowers, as always. Now, after this was initially done in Texas, they shut it down. STEM Express.
They didn't expose any private medical stuff. They showed them keeping babies alive.
That's right. What they did was they're going to start a prosecution here in Texas. Then that quietly went away. Because they weren't going to push it here. But now, months after this, they're starting it back up in California. And so that's the key thing. The tape that was released yesterday, a new tape, the woman said, well, I have to be careful who's in the room when I do this because we have a law here in Arizona. If the baby shows any signs of life, it has to go to the hospital. So I have to be careful who is in the room so that I can get an intact baby. Talking about how she had to do training to get stronger so she could rip the child up before it comes out of the mother. So this is a full spectrum that goes from abortion to the...
And by the way, it's come out in federal court. Most of these top partial birth abortionists are Satanists. And this is in the news. I mean, who could kill babies that are 8 months old? They are devil worshipers. So Craig, I want to bring Don Salazar back in because you've been waiting, Don. Jump back in. We'll get final comments from Craig here. But, I mean, just like you can have History Channel and Discovery Channel TV shows. You can be a famous Navy SEAL, probably one of the most 4 or 5 most famous, super loved by everybody in the military, a patriot, and you can't have a U-caring funding deal to make a movie about sex trafficking to expose it. Good God.
They can't bear it. They cannot bear to be exposed. They cannot stand it. That is their greatest threat.
We'll come back to you for final comments in a moment, Craig. But I just called you back. Look up an address you want us to give. I'm not made out of money, but I only invest in the truth. And I can tell this is the key. So $10,000 was given earlier. They blocked it. $100,000 is coming now. And, folks, that's a whole employee we could hire for the year and all their taxes and everything. It doesn't matter. I'm so committed. Please donate to us at InfoWarsStore.com. Buy the X2. They're trying to block us on that. Maybe our last shipment. Just please. I just want to beat them. I have a compulsion to help children. I have a compulsion to fight these people. That's what I mean. It's just fighting them and then blocking us and the things they do. And they're so pathetic. As a man, I ask myself, how is scum ruling me? And it's just let's defeat them. But if you just support us, spread the videos, get the workout, we're going to win. So Don Salazar, other points on this, to see you caring, $50,000 donated an hour, so they shut it down as it goes viral, to help children in sex slavery by respected federal law enforcement officers who have worked for the CIA, Navy SEAL team leaders, you name it. They're not credible.
Yeah, I'm with you, Alex. These pedophiles are really the lowest scum of the earth, and I think what Mr. Sawyer was doing was pretty noble, and for you caring to shut it down, that's inexplicable, and without them giving a reason for it is even worse. I don't know what the next headline I'm going to write is. Maybe protecting pedophiles. Why is you caring shutting down a pedophile exposing network?
Just, you know, famous Navy SEAL or famous TV host Navy SEAL banned from reporting on pedophiles. I mean,
yeah. Yeah, that would be a good headline, too. I mean, something has to be done. The only power I have is to write about it, and you can be assured that I'm going to exercise that power to the fullest.
What I don't get is that they think this intimidates us. Like, when they threaten me, and I don't want to go into all of it because people use it against me, and there's a lot of stuff behind the scenes. I've had confirmed, and it turns out U.S. government agencies who are always being demonized are actually the ones that later confirmed this, but I've known that I had like foreign government agencies funding private corporate ops against me and my family. I mean, I'm not bitching about it, but they did stuff that was just horrible. And I know Craig's gone through some of the stuff, might have been, but just stuff we can't even say unless he wants to say it on air. But it's like they attack you and it doesn't make you feel weaker. It makes you actually transcend into being strong. It's like everything just goes quiet. And then you realize you've got to make it to the end of that. You've got to defeat these people because you're in a death battle. They've got their hands around your throat and around your country's throat, and they're trying to strangle you. They want you to be quiet about it while they do it. I'm like, I'm not going to be quiet. And then I just think about, and then the people that are our enemies, I would have no satisfaction taking a meat cleaver and chopping the top of their head off because they're, like Craig said, they're not even people. We're doing it for the innocents. We're not doing it to crush these scumbags. So, David Knight, then Craig, go ahead.
If you just look at Dennis Hastert, for example.
Oh, God, a groomer for the Republicans.
Yeah, he was the Speaker of the House longer than any other Republican, maybe longer than any Democrat. I know it was longer than any Republican. This guy was hand-selected by power. Because he was a pedophile. This was a guy who was nothing but a wrestling coach at a high school.
But it shows there's a rebellion that he was brought down.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. That's the other part of it.
It's a rebellion against the pedophile rule.
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely.
Sorry, go ahead, David.
But isn't it interesting that here's a guy, he's not a great thinker, hasn't accomplished anything, he's not a great orator. He's an absolute zero when you saw Dennis Hastert. I mean, look at him and it's like, how did this guy become Speaker? Well, we found out how he became Speaker.
And I bet he was abused.
Handpicked because he was a pedophile.
Women don't want him, so he only feels confident screwing a two-year-old baby.
Yeah, but he was. They put him forward. He didn't get there by strength of character or accomplishments or knowledge or anything, or orator.
I want to explain some of these pedophiles. The sexiest thing is a big, powerful woman full of life and life force. That's what a man wants, not a kid, guys. I don't understand. I'm sorry. Go ahead, David. I'm ranting.
Well, I'm just saying that shows the power of politics. Who's there? And this is something that just happened. We're not talking about something happened 100 years ago or 50 years ago. This just happened.
Gloves are off.
He was.
I realize I'm going all out.
When he was the Speaker of the House. So this is an ongoing thing. This is the world that we live in. And as you pointed out before, Alex, you know, we don't struggle against flesh and blood, but against spiritual wickedness in high places. Dennis Hastert. Think of Dennis Hastert. That's the GOP establishment right now that picked him. That's the kind of guy.
There are kids in cages all over this country right now They hadn't seen their mommy in 2 years, and these pedophiles line up and torture the hell out of them. And we owe it to humanity and our species to get out of this TV trance and say no. And Greg Sawyer is saying no, and all these other people I know. Trump's got military operations wiping out al-Qaeda bases in the U.S. I'm just going to say it all. He's wiping them out. Obama is a Muslim. They had set up leagues. That's why Trump is just ignoring their attacks. He just is trying to wipe out their plan before they get him. And that Trump is so selfless. It makes me just, it is such an epic time. Because I've been on air 22 years. I don't normally sit here and cry on air every 5 minutes. The energy is so high. The battle for this republic is so big. This is so real. People need to know. There's Trump. Got to do something about these missing children grabbed by perverts. Too many innocents. Fast trial, death penalty. You know, to Craig, enough of this. The point is, we just want survival for our kids. We want a future. Men have to stand up again. You're doing it. And they've blocked you from getting funding. So I don't know if you had time. Give us an address. It needs to be registered mail, folks, because they'll try to intercept it. And I'm going to send you $100,000 today, which is nothing. I am honored to do that because I know you're for real. That's why they're so scared of you. We need millions to go to you to get this. Let's go to your site, vetsforchildrescue.org, and show in just a few weeks since you were already trying to investigate and they targeted you and you said, you know what, next level. Now they're scared. Now they're watching you. Now you know what, we're watching them. And if the whole Civil War kicks off, all these globalists, you know, good luck. So you got MI6, CIA, Rangers, Delta Force, the German intelligence, German Special Forces, Special Services, FBI claims are involved. All this going on, what do we do right now to defeat these people? Skip the break.
Well, all right, yeah, we can't be deterred. We cannot be deterred. This is just the first foot placed on that battlefield. So, yeah, they're going to resist, but we got to beat them. And,
but doesn't it show how fast they hit us that they're scared?
Say again?
Doesn't it show how fast they hit us that they're scared?
Yeah. I smell fear, like a wolf moving in for the kill. I smell fear, man. So, yeah, we're just getting started, Alex. So this is par for the course. Here we go. We're coming.
Well, you're a humble guy, but I'm skipping the break. Just a few more minutes of, like, recapping what we talked about hours ago. They banned you caring, trying to do money as a Discovery Channel, History Channel, you know, guy that does shows. You're not allowed to cover sex trafficking.
Bad stuff. Looks bad on you caring. Boy, they are looking. I still am waiting for a phone call right now. I'm waiting for them to respond, and they are not. They cannot articulate what their claimed discrepancy is. So that only leaves us with an assumption to make about their actions, which looks very, very poor. Looks very bad. This is a straightforward situation. There should be no discrepancy. And if it is, they should be able to come right out with it. Oh, yeah, you know, you made a typo or this needs to happen or that. We could, you know, if they'd articulate what their discrepancy claim is, we could address that and move on.
I just don't get the intimidation power of the pedo networks. God, they got power, man. Paul Watson has got a big report coming out soon that he says is so devastating. And I can't tell everybody. I just got the stuff.
So right now I'm wondering, what is UCaring hiding from? What are they hiding from that they can't answer the question? They're claiming there's a discrepancy, and we're saying, let us know what that is. We'll satisfy that and rage on.
How's that work? If $50,000 an hour got donated, they shut it off because they could see it going viral. Facebook, Twitter, they all got scared. It was all over the place. Oh, my God. Millions were about to come in to expose pedophilia, as Trump is exposing it. So then it triggers and they block you. Does the money people donated go back to them? Or does the $10,000, there's another $10,000, does that go to you? Or what happens?
If I don't know. I didn't anticipate them just shutting down the thing after people had already donated. So they'd better give those back to the people that donated it. Or UCaring would
sure.
Be
sure. So are we going to put a P.O. box? How do people register mail so there's a record? Give money to vetsforchildrescue.org. How do they do it right now?
Well, I'd sent in an email or a physical mailing address, but I'd rather not have that on the air right now. So
I understand.
To
we weren't ready for that. We got to get this money in. Now I know for sure. I'll sell my house. I want to give everything I've got to this. I realize now.
I'm sure we'll be updating the article so they can put that information there where people can fund this, as well as what we finally hear from You Caring.
All right.
Yeah.
Yeah, let's hold You Caring accountable for this, their claim. Let's find out what their answer is.
Remember, 2 hours ago, Craig, or an hour and a half ago, we were talking, and I said we're censored in live time, and you are too. What does this say to you as any terrorism federal officer? What does this tell you?
Well, you know, I think there's a perfect meme for it. It shows a B-17 with flak, you know, exploding in the air all around it, and it says, hey, if you're taking flak, you know, you're over the target. So if they're willing to pull this sort of desperate antic to shut up a guy who's just straightforward and trying to tell the truth, then it looks like it's very, very, like I'm shooting straight for the medulla, so to speak. It wasn't sniper talk, but
I'm not kissing your ass, but as one of the leaders, the most elite SEAL teams and all the things you've done, that's why they demonize veterans. That's why they do all this. They are so scared before they have the robots take over and all the automation. They're so scared of that last line of patriots, men standing up for humanity. And so they are absolutely crapping their pants, Craig. So I know we're over the target. Both my grandfathers were in the Army Air Corps. And one of them, I've never talked about it because he got shot down and a bunch of other stuff. But it was a big story. But the point was, the other one was a B-17 pilot, a North Africa bomb in Italy. And then he went into Italy after that and did his missions. But he just said, no, it was the craziest thing. He said, before I ever heard that on the news, he said, we see the flak clouds and we steer into them. And I realized that's what you're doing, that's what we're doing. And the enemy thinks we're afraid of them. We're steering right into their fire.
Yeah. Turn the ship straight into that iceberg and throttle up. I mean, that's my muscle memory. That's where I'm at. I already see that they're going to suppress anything that I try to do to, you know, take care of my family, feed my family, or make a good life for myself. So I want to go straight after what it is that I care about most. And right here in the continental United States, what I can do is help the kids, man. And the more I learn about it, and the more pervasive I learn that this pedophile thing is, the more I have to be involved. So here we go, man.
Craig, let me ask you this question. In all your missions in 25, 30 years in special operations, is it, for me, just as a citizen, as an American, this is the true defense of the Republic and the world? I mean, is this not the most important mission ever, to secure the homeland?
It really is. It seems to be like this whole dark society that whatever these people are into that involve pedophile activity and abuse with these rituals, it seems like some really dark stuff. And it seems to be the people that are in so many cases in positions of power and have a lot of control and ownership of media. And it just the people that I know that are neck deep in the investigations, are even if they're not Christians or spiritual kind of people, they're not looking at it that way. They're just saying, Craig, this is evil. What we're seeing is evil. This is just so despicable. It kind of goes beyond anything we've seen anywhere else on the face of the planet.
It's interdimensional. These people are proving themselves to be rulers of the earth to kill it. And these people are, let's be frank, the Bible says it's fallen, you know, it's interdimensional, it's an anti-human outside force that's creating an army of people that will prove themselves to hurt children. Because if you'll hurt children, you'll hurt anybody. This is an army they're forging, and our human army is about to defeat it. Final comments, sir.
And that's the key, the human army. And when I look at Craig here, and I'm concerned what you mentioned, Alex, about the future with autonomous killing robots, or robots that are not necessarily autonomous but are under the control of just one or two people, instead of having human soldiers who have a conscience, who have a mind, who have a sense of right and wrong like Craig Sawyer. It's great that we have people like that now. What I'm concerned about is the future, where they remove so many of our troops that were the human.
Perfect final question. Quick comment, Craig Sawyer. You got to come back on tomorrow. It's a big controversy. No, tomorrow is Saturday. We got to come on Sunday, 4 to 6 p.m. You've got to come back on, Craig. This is a big deal. We can't just drop this. But, yeah, what about how they're trying to move humans out of the decision-making process?
Well, I don't have a lot to say about that other than in the Marine Corps, I remember they pounded into us, we have the responsibility to refuse to carry out an unlawful order. And it wasn't, and that was standard, man. It was like, do righteous stuff. And our leaders were all about, you know, protecting the Constitution and carrying out lawful orders from the commander in chief, and that we were not
and
to
that's
carry
why the
out
left always
orders.
Demonized the military. While they were giving in unconstitutional orders, they were claiming it was the enemy because it was the best people we had.
That's right. And it's not going to be swarms of killing drones or robots on the battlefield are not going to be doing the right thing. They're not going to see that they've got a duty. They're just going to follow commands mindlessly as a robot.
I agree. Yeah, Don Salazar, quick final comment. You're sitting there. Go ahead. Final comment.
I was just making updates to the page saying that we were terminated by you caring, but I do plan on writing a subsequent follow-up article documenting you caring and calling them out for basically terminating this page without any explanation.
And also where they can donate to.
Craig, I'm ready for you to get on a plane here right now. Give that $100,000 check for your operation. I think you should be here Sunday. If you can't, it's fine next week. We've got to go full on. They're scared of this. The main flak attack is here. Their main base is right over. We got to get in there and get this done. So we'll talk to you after the show. Thank you for letting me barge in, David Knight.
No problem. Oh, this is very important. Very important that this would happen, that it would happen so quickly, immediately after you have him on to talk about this, they shut down the funding.
Nightly news tonight, 7 o'clock Central, Infowars.com. The enemy does not want you to hear this broadcast. Spread the links. All right. Thank you so much, crew. Great job. This is the Infowar.